Hey, what's going on, you guys? It's Star Wars Dojo here today with a brand new video. Hope you guys are having an amazing day so far. Of course, I got sick. I promise it's not C19. I got tested, came back negative, everything good. That's why this video is coming out pretty late. The new episode of The Book of Boba Fett came out, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. There were some parts I liked, some parts I disliked, and I'm going to go over everything. We're going to get right into the video. Alright, so the episode opens up to 8D8 showing Boba where Jabba's land has been divided into. He explains how it was divided into three families. The Trandoshans took the city center, the Aqualish took the workers' district, and the Clutunians took the starport and the upper sprawl. He explained that Bib Fortuna, after Jabba died, took his place, and he relied on easy alliances to preserve his title and basically stay in charge. He explains that where Boba's land is right now is owned by the mayor, Mok Shays, along with all the other areas. They are pretty much all also ran by the mayor. Then scene cuts to the guards bringing in a shop owner, and he explains that he is a watermonger and how he is insulted by how much crime there is and how it's not being resolved by Boba. He's very insulted that Boba's not doing anything about it, and insulted that they don't take Boba seriously. And he talks about these cyborg punks that keep taking his water and stealing from him, and asks for Boba to resolve it. Later that night, Boba and Shenik Fang go down the streets of Tatooine to go find the cyberpunks essentially taking the water from the shopkeeper, and finds them in the back alley next to a fire with all the water. As Boba and Fang and his guards get closer, they do realize these kids are half cyborg and half human. They explain to Boba that this shopkeeper is overpricing his water, and that he's charging them a month's wages for a week's water, and how it's too expensive, and that's why they're stealing. Boba says, well, if you can't find a job and you can't afford it, why not work for me? He takes his helmet off, and he offers them to work for him. The shopkeeper gets mad at Boba, comes out, and is yelling that he's not doing anything with these cyborg punks. Boba gives him 500 credits to cover the 1,300 credits that the kids owe him, and to lower his water prices. If he wishes to still sell his water in Boba's territory. Boba tells these kids to follow him back to the palace, and they hop on their fancy, super clean bikes, which is really funny because it doesn't really seem like they're from Tatooine. The scene immediately cuts to Boba in his back to tank again, and he starts dreaming again. He starts having visions of Kamino, and we're seeing the same clip that we saw in episode 2. We see Boba and the Tuskens. Boba hops on a Bantha and leaves the Tuskens to go to a town. He rides his Bantha to town. He gets into town to find speared stormtrooper helmets, like we saw in The Mandalorian. The exact same ones we saw in The Mandalorian. And this is how we find out that The Mandalorian takes place 5 years after the moments of this flashback that we're seeing right now. Boba goes in to speak with the Pikes to get their toll money, and the Pikes explain to Boba that they already paid a group of people that say they work with the Tuskens called the Nikito Sand Riders. And the Pikes explain that they won't pay the Tuskens double, you know, two times. They were told that the two groups are the same, and so they're not going to pay twice. It doesn't make sense. Boba understands and tells the Pikes that they won't be hearing from them anymore, explaining that he's going to go pretty much destroy them. Boba hops back on the Bantha to ride back to the Tusken camp, where he sees smoke cloud in the distance going over the sand dunes of Tatooine. He gets closer and he finds his fellow Tusken village has been burnt to crisps. He walks through, and anyone and everyone is dead, including the Tusken leader. The only one we don't see is the female Tusken anywhere. We don't see her dead body or ashes or anything, you know. So we think that she might still be alive, or she escaped, which we might see in episode 4. Boba walks to a tent, and we see the same symbol of the group of bikers on the wall that we saw Boba killed in the bar, the group of bikers that raided that family's house. So their village was burnt down by them, which we can see makes Boba extremely angry. And those are the Nikito Sand Riders that Boba was told about, that got the Tuskens toll money. Boba piles the dead Tuskens and burns them out of respect, and he starts walking out of the desert with his bantha. When abruptly he wakes up with the water pouring out of his bacta tank, immediately grabbed by the throat by Black Kersantan, and thrown around several times very, very hard, Boba gets thrown over by his Tusken staff and he stabs Black Kersantan in the stomach with it. He gets tossed around more before being picked up and being crushed so hard we hear Boba's back snapping. We see Boba's toes immediately go limp, and he is immediately saved by his new cyborg recruits. They end up fighting Black Kersantan, and the guards come up, and we see, it's such a cool fight scene. We see Black Kersantan pummel down the stairs with the guards, and he beats one so badly that it doesn't get up, and then he bites the neck of another one before a button being pressed, and he gets knocked down into the Rancor pit. It was kind of weird. It was very quick. It was very fast. It didn't seem like it lasted that long. It went by pretty quick, but we kind of got a little glimpse of how dangerous Black Kersantan is. Boba comes out in his robes, which was really weird. We'd think he would be, like, suited up, ready to fight, because how would he know they, you know, took care of Black Kersantan? It's kind of weird, you know? How does he not know he's going to come down and everybody's dead? But anyways, the scene changes to Boba and Fang eating a massive feast, and Boba's disappointed and doesn't know how to respond to this. When he's immediately interrupted by the droid telling Boba that the twins are there. The Hutts. the twins show up and apologize to Boba about the assassination attempt. They admitted they sent Black Kersantan to kill him, and they offer him a gift. The gift that they bring him is a giant baby Rancor. Boba brings out Black Kersantan in chains, and he tells the twins tell Boba that the area on Tatooine that was previously owned by Jabba the Hutt has already been claimed by another syndicate, and that it is wise to leave and to sell Black Kersantan himself. They need to get out of there quickly. So that kind of just goes to show that the Hutts didn't want to mess with whoever this was. Because the Hutts are the Hutts, you know, they control everything. So the fact that there's somebody that's scaring them away to not want to fight is pretty interesting. Anyways, Boba ends up letting Black Kersantan go just randomly out in the wild, just unhooks his chains and runs off. And the scene cuts to Boba and the Rancor trainer go into the dungeon where the Rancor is stored in the palace. Boba is told that he can eventually ride the Rancor. Boba is said that he wants to ride it and he wants to bond with it, and was told that after they removed the eye masks that the Rancor bonds with the first person it sees. And they remove the masks, and Boba is immediately bonded with that Rancor, which was pretty cool. We didn't know about that. Eventually, the droid interrupts again and says the mayor won't be able to see them for 20 days. And so Boba and Fennec start riding to the mayor immediately as fast as they can. They get there, and Boba speaks with the mayor's assistant, and the mayor's assistant goes in the back and immediately locks the door. Boba tries to open the door, and Fennec stabs a knife in the door console, opening the door, and the man made a run for it. Boba and Fennec look in the back, and they don't see him. They come outside, and they see the assistant driving away. Boba sends his cyborg punks to go chase him. A long chase scene happens. It was pretty long. It was kind of boring, to be honest. I mean, not much happened, but eventually they made him crash, and the assistant, Boba lands with his jetpack finally, and the assistant tells them that the mayor is working with the pikes. That whole scene was really weird. I don't know why Boba didn't just fly and shoot him, you know, in the first place, but lately we've been seeing Boba being kind of soft, and it's weird. Anyways, then the scene cuts to the travel ship landing at the spaceport on Tatooine. We see over a dozen pikes leaving the ship, and the information is immediately told to Boba via hologram from one of the cyborg punks. It's so weird. They're such an odd group of people. I wouldn't really imagine them being on Tatooine, so it's kind of weird. But anyways, the episode ends. I rate this episode, maybe because of Black Kersantan's scene and the stuff we saw, I would rate it a 7 out of 10. But honestly, that was the only really exciting part, besides the Rancor as well. But not much happened. It was kind of slow. We're still seeing Boba not really do much. He's just getting his butt handed to him every single time. And we're kind of wanting to see more Boba action, you know, of like Boba Fett and Legends in the comics. But anyways, that was it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Please leave a like. Please subscribe. And I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And yeah, hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and may the Force be with you always.